Hey everybody, welcome back to our channel. I want to talk a little bit today about the rising home prices and interest rates in the Philippines and just talk about the affordability and the cost of land and homes. So I kind of wanted to get into a little bit about, is the cost of the Philippines still affordable and cheap in the opinion of most foreigners? We've got a lot of groundskeeping going on right now, so it's a little bit noisy in the background with lawnmowers and stuff, but we'll try to get through it anyway. We just got an email a couple of days ago about our interest rate going up almost 2 points on our home loan. So our interest rate just went up by quite a bit. And luckily for us, we are just within a few months of finishing our home loan. So it's not gonna affect us greatly. But if we were just starting or looking for a home loan, it would be pretty high in my opinion right now. So the current interest rate for us that we got was a little over 9%. 9.8, so almost 10. So pretty high interest rate. A lot higher than what we were paying, which we kind of felt like was a little bit high already. So that just, we just got that notice a couple of days ago. So our loan payment increased a little bit. We did it a few years back and we're almost done. So in our case, we're doing an early payoff and we're looking at 5 years. I think we'll be right at 5 years, just about, when we get it done. And we went with a longer loan than that, but we're just trying to pay it off early. We've been looking at properties quite a bit because we were wanting to find a rental property or some kind of an investment property. And it's been about, 2 months since we bought our lot?
Yeah.
It's back about the end of May or first of June. And the thing I wanted to mention about that is when we first started looking at that property, the developer was asking 1,500 pesos per square meter, and we were able to get a discount from that by paying cash, but 1,500 was the asking price for the lots, and then they just raised their price
recently,
about 2 weeks ago.
I think June. Yeah.
Yeah, 2 or 3 weeks ago, the price went up to 1,800 per square meter. So I don't know if that had anything to do with the interest rate going up, because I'm sure that the developer has that property financed because it's a very large farm, mango farm, that they subdivided and are selling the lots. So they raised their price from 1,500 to 1,800. So if we were to be interested in a lot there now in that development, it would be 1,800 pesos per square meter. So that's two examples of things that has affected us personally, things that we've seen personally, increase in interest rate and increase in land prices. We've been looking at rental houses, rental properties, just homes really, for sale that could be converted into a rental property. And have you been surprised at all about the prices, or are they kind of what you've expected from what you remember prices being? Because Cecile's been doing most of the looking at the property, searching.
I don't know, it raised a little bit because I've seen the small square meters that they're selling for overpriced.
You feel like they're higher?
Yeah, it's higher than before.
Yeah. So it could be that the cost is going up across the board on all the properties, all the homes. In Cecile's opinion, she feels like homes are higher now in our area than they were just last year, maybe. Wait for this lawnmower to go by. So one thing that affects us, if we were looking for property in our city of Balanga, that city is really developing quickly.
Yeah.
It's growing, it's changing. They just had an SM Mall come in there. They built a new SM Mall. A lot of new businesses coming in, and property prices really increasing. A lot of people coming into the area, and of course it's kind of a supply and demand situation. There's only so many lots available and a certain number of people wanting those lots. So as the land gets fewer options and the people become more buyers, price is going to go up. So you might be a little bit surprised at the price of land and homes in the Philippines if you're not really familiar with the country, because I think a lot of people just assume everything is cheap there. Land is kind of the exception to that, I think. Land can be pretty expensive and homes can be expensive. But comparing it to the United States, you can definitely find larger homes much cheaper, but maybe it's not cheaper, as cheap, right? As what you're thinking.
Yeah, the cheaper land is out from the city, mm-hmm. or in the province.
Yeah,
you would get 100,000 pesos only.
Yeah, the
$1,000, you can buy 50,000 pesos, which is roughly $1,000 mm-hmm. for a property in the province.
Yeah, something to build a house on.
Yeah, just to build a house, a simple house.
So one of the main factors is going to be the location of the property. Of course, the more populated the city, the more modern the city, the higher the prices are going to be. And the more isolated you are out of like a province area or more of a farming area, land prices are going to be lower. But one of the main things to keep in mind about that also is infrastructure, because the further you get out, the worse the roads get and the harder the access is to your property. You know, you may have a really hard time accessing your land if it's too far out in the province. So you definitely want to check into that. Electricity can be an issue. Internet certainly could be an issue if you're out in a remote area. So infrastructure is really something to consider when you're looking at properties. And, you know, thinking you might have found a really cheap property, there may be a good reason why it's very cheap. So where we're located, it's kind of a medium-sized city. We're in between Angeles City, which is a big city, a lot of foreigners, and Manila. And then we're also about the same distance to Subic as we are to Angeles City, which are three places where there's a lot of foreigners and three places that are a little higher, more expensive to live than where we live. A lot of foreigners end up out in the province, I think, because in a lot of cases, that's where their wife family is. Maybe their wife has some land already. So you'll see a lot of foreigners build out in the province, and it works out well for them. But you just have to really check the area and make sure it's going to work for you. But we don't seem to have a lot of foreigners really in our city. Bataan doesn't seem to be extremely popular with foreigners, but we do have some. We run into some on occasion around town, but not nearly like other cities. There's certain cities you can go to where there's a lot of foreigners, and I think that kind of drives some of the prices up also, because people that have more money to spend for rent and buying homes and things like that is going to increase the price.
And also some business owner are building now in the highway.
In our area?
In our area. That's why it's getting higher the price.
Well, this guy's making it really hard to finish this video. He decided to mow right in front of us all of a sudden. So our city has a bit of an issue with flooding, especially in the past. I think they've made improvements on the drainage system and things, but flooding has been an issue. Where our subdivision is, it's not an issue for us at all, but the surrounding areas, flooding has been an issue, and in the plaza area, because the river runs right through the city. So flooding has been a problem there, but Cecile mentioned they're starting to build now more along the highway, and it's not a flooding area. And then also a lot of new businesses coming in along that highway, so prices along that area especially going up. So you can still find cheap properties in the Philippines, and you can find good deals probably inside some nice cities, but as with anything else, costs are going up and real estate's no exception. And real estate might be the most obvious increase, I think, of anything other than maybe food and gas.
Sometimes
Yeah.
It's cheap.
And also the sellers sometimes will be open to offers.
Yeah.
A bargain with you a little bit sometimes. So you can always talk people down some, but not everybody. Some people are really set on their price. So we just wanted to mention kind of how that affected us recently and let everybody know, prices and property in the Philippines may not be as cheap as what you're thinking. I was surprised at the price of land and stuff when we started looking, because you hear about everything being cheap in the Philippines and you assume land is also, but land and homes and all that, a little more limited there. And I guess, with a big population, plus you have foreigners coming in, living there, makes the price and all that more in demand going up.
And also some of the Filipinos like to live away from the city because of prices are going up high. They'd rather to live in the remote.
Live outside the city, yeah. So that was another reason why we bought our farm property, just to kind of get outside the city and have a getaway. So
yeah.
Hopefully that all works out well for us. We'll be developing that over the next several years. Well, I have a sudden urge to go home and do yard work. So I guess I'll wrap up this video. Maybe I'll go home and do some lawn mowing.
What?
After seeing that guy going back and forth with the lawnmower, it kind of motivated me now to do yard work. So thanks for watching, everybody. Take care, and we'll see you on the next video.